Hello everyone, this is in continuation to linear programming problem wherein we were seeing special cases of solutions which are possible in linear programming problem. The next special case is alternate optima solution or multiple optimum solution. Again, we'll understand this through an example. Example goes like this. Solve the following linear programming problem graphically. Maximize Z, which is equal to 20 times X2 subject to, 20 times X1 plus 10 times X2 subject to 10X1 plus 5X2 less than or equal to 50, 6X1 plus 10X2 less than or equal to 60, 4X1 plus 12X2 less than or equal to 48. And then X1, X2 are non-negativity restrictions. So first of all, let us convert the inequations to equations. Let L1 be 10x1 plus 5x2 equal to 50. Call it as equation 1. L2 be 6x1 plus 10x2 equal to 60. Then L3 be 4x1 plus 12x2 equal to 48. Now let us find out the coordinates for each of the line. First, choosing L1, substituting X1 for 0, the first term will become 0, then we have 5X2 equal to 50, which means X2 will be 10. Then substituting X2 for 0, second term will become 0, 10X1 equal to 50 means X1 will be 5. So for the first line, the coordinates are 0, 10, and then 5, 0. Move on to next second line. Same way. First, substitute x1 for 0. Then 10x2 is equal to 60. It will be, that means x2 is 6. Substitute x2 for 0. Then we have 6x1 equal to 60, which means x1 is 10. So, coordinates 0, 6. 10, 0. Same way, let's do it for L3. Substitute X1 for 0. We get 12X2 equal to 48, which means X2 is 4. Substitute X2 for 0. So we get 4X1 equal to 48, which means X1 is 12. So here the coordinates are 0, 4, 12, 0. We may note the maximum number in X1 is 12, minimum is 0, and in X2 maximum is 10, minimum is 0. Accordingly, we'll draw the graph. Yeah, this is our X1 axis, this is our X2 axis. As we saw, X1's maximum is 10. Two, four, six, eight, 10. Here again. Now, let us draw first line 1. Coordinates are 0, 10. X1 is 0, X2 is 10. Second coordinate, 5, 0. 5 is in between 4 and 6. 5, 0. So, I should put Now let us join these two points. This is our, see, we may notice all the inequations are less than or equal to. So we can easily do the shading after drawing all the graphs or the all the lines. Second line, 0, 6. X1 is 0, X2 is 6. Second coordinate, 10, 0. That is here. Now join these two points. This is our line 2. Okay. Then line 3, 0, 4. X1 is 0, X2 is 4. And 12, 0. X1 is 12. Oh, X1 is 12 means somewhere here it will come. So I can join these two points. That is our L3. Now, the common region for all these lines is this. That is our common region. Let me call this as O, this as A, this as B, this as C. So I'll say here, OABC is the common feasible region and the corner points are OAB and C. Now, what is O? It is nothing but the origin, 0, 0. Then A is 0, 4. B is what? We may notice it is the intersection of line 3 and line 1. So L1 intersection L3. What is C? It is 5, 0. Now we need to find out B. That can be found out by solving equation 1 and 3. I mean, if I solve L1 and L3 or 1 and 3 equations, I will get it. One thing I may notice, if I multiply 4 into 2.5, I will get 10. So I will do one thing. I'll multiply third equation by 2.5. So what will happen? 4 times 2.5 is 10x1 plus 12 into 2.5. 12 into 2.5 is 30. Then that is equal to what? 48 into 2.5. We get 120. Let me call this as fourth equation. This we will, we will subtract that fourth equation with the first equation. Means I'll write first equation. 5 times x2 is equal to 50. This is our first equation. Let us solve this. Means I will subtract 4 minus 1. I get 25 times x2 equal to 70, which means x2 is 70 by 25. 5 5s are 25. 5, 14 or 17. So x2 is 17. Now, let me substitute this in first equation. 10 times x1 plus 5 times 14 by 5 is equal to 15. Which means, let me cancel this. 10x1 is equal to 50 minus 14, which is 36, or x1 is 36 by 10, or 218s are 25, sir. So 18 by 5. So our point B is nothing but 18 by 5, comma 14 by 5. So we got now only one is left. I can write that 18 by 5, comma 14 by 5. Now, what is our z? Z is 20x1 plus 10x2. Z is 20x1 plus 10x2. Now, let us find out each corner point. What is the z value? Za, first of all, zo is 20 times 0 plus 10 times 0, which will be 0. And za, 20 times what it is, a, 0 comma 4. First value is 0. Next value is 4. This will become 40. Z of B is 20 times 18 by 5 plus 10 times 14 by 5. This goes with this 4 times. This goes with this 2 times. This is 28. This is 72. Ultimately, it is 100. Then Z of C is 20 times, what is C? 5 comma 0. X1 is 5. X2 is 0. This also 100. We are interested in finding out the max Z. And we may notice max Z is 100 and it occurs in two places. Since it is occurring in two different points, it indicates alternative possible solution, means I will say optimal solution for this problem is max z is 100 and corresponding x1, x2. One possible answer is 18 by 5 and 14 by 5. Or the alternatively, x1 is 5, x2 is 0. So you have got two solutions. Both are giving you the optimal value of 100. That is why this particular special case is called alternative optimal solution or multiple optimal solution. In case if you find the contents of this video to be useful to you, I request you to like it, share it with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you.